Hey Angular folks, it's Brian. After many years of building with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. You know those view toggle buttons? Grid view, list view, they're everywhere. Gmail has them, GitHub has them, pretty much every app with a list has them. Ever wanted to add one to your Angular app? Today, I'll show you how to build one that's incredibly flexible. It can switch between simple CSS classes or completely different component trees. And you can manage the state externally or let it handle everything internally. All right, let's see what we're working with here. We've got a simple Angular app with a product listing that has these view toggle buttons here. When I click them, absolutely nothing happens. The buttons are there, they look nice, but they're basically just decoration at this point. Let's jump into the code and see what's going on. First, let's look at the root app component. Here, we've got our view mode toggle component. This contains the button bar with the list view toggle. Below that, we're looping through a products list to render a product item component for each one. Okay, now let's take a look at the code for the toggle component to see what's happening there. Here, we've got our two buttons, one for grid view, one for list view. But what's missing? There's no click handlers, no state management, nothing to actually make these buttons, you know, work. Okay, let's look at the TypeScript now. Look at that. It's basically empty. No properties, no methods, no logic whatsoever. All right, time to bring this component to life. Let's start by adding some actual functionality here. First thing we need is a way to track which view mode we're in. Now, I could use a regular input here, but I'm going to use something even better for this scenario, Angular's model input. Now you might be wondering, why model instead of input? Great question. Model inputs are specifically designed for two-way binding. No more adding both an input and an output for the same piece of state. The parent component can both read the value and update it, and we can use that banana in a box syntax to do this, which is what we need to do in this example. More on that in a minute. Now, what we need is a list mode type for this input. Let's create a union type where the value can either be grid or list. Then we can use this to properly type our model input. Let's give it an initial value of list. Okay, now we have a value to store the state. Let's add a method to update it. Let's call it set and give it a mode parameter. Within this method, we'll simply set the mode based on the value passed to this parameter. All right, that should be everything we need here, so let's switch to the component HTML and make these buttons actually do something. First, let's add a click handler to our grid button and then use our set method to set the mode to grid. So now, when someone clicks this button, it should properly update the mode. And while we're here, let's also add visual feedback so users know which view is active. Let's use class binding to bind an active class when the mode value is set to grid. This active class and our CSS will handle making it look selected. Now, let's do the same thing for our list button. Let's add the click event with the set method passing a value of list this time. And then we'll add the active class when the mode value is set to list. Perfect. Our buttons now have brains. They can think, they can act, they can even remember which one is active. Now, let's open our root component and connect everything up. First, we need to track the view mode in this component. Let's add a signal here called view mode. We'll type this using our list mode type from the view mode toggle, and we'll set the initial value to list here too. Now, here's where the magic happens. On our view mode toggle component, we're going to add a two-way binding. Instead of just passing an input, we'll use the banana in a box syntax with the mode input, and then we'll pass it the view mode signal. Those square brackets and parentheses together mean we're both reading from and writing to our view mode signal. When the toggle component updates its internal mode, our parent's view mode automatically updates too. No event emitters, no manual subscriptions, just clean declarative binding. Now let's actually use this mode to change how our products display. On the product item component, I'll add conditional classes. So when we're in grid mode, the product items get a grid class. When we're in list mode, they get a list class. The product item component's CSS provides styles for these classes to completely change its layout. Okay, that should be everything that we need, so let's save this and check it out. Boom. Look at that. Click grid, the layout changes. Click list, it switches back. Our dead buttons have come alive. This is pretty cool, right? It's really flexible. It allows for us to add our reusable view mode toggle component and then do whatever we need to do when the mode changes. But what happens when your project manager says we need completely different components for each view? In this case, it was a simple class toggle, but a lot of the time we may need to show completely different markup or components. And in these cases, it would be nice to bottle up that common logic into the component itself so that we don't need to repeat ourselves every time we use it. So that's what we're going to do now. Let's switch back over to our view mode toggle component HTML. After our nav element, let's add some conditional content regions. First, let's add a condition for grid mode. Then let's add an NG content slot here and select on an element with a grid attribute. So what's happening here? Well, this creates a slot that will only accept content marked with a grid attribute. And with the condition, it will only render when in grid mode. Now let's add the same thing for list mode. A conditional slot selecting an element with a list attribute. Now this allows us to handle the list mode state internally, which is probably what we want to do in most cases. So now our toggle component has become a smart container. It's not just switching classes, it's actually controlling which projected content gets displayed. All right, let's open the root component and put this all together. First, I need to import some specialized components for the list views so that we can use them. In the real world, these would be purpose-built components. The grid card shows a big image with minimal info, while the list row is optimized for scanning lots of information quickly. In this case, though, they look exactly like the grid and list view of the current product item. Now, we can remove the product item component from the template entirely. Also, we can remove the import. Now we can even remove the view mode signal and the mode model binding. We don't need it. The toggle component will handle its own state internally. Now, inside our view mode toggle element, right after the title, we are going to add our grid view content. Let's add a div with the grid attribute. That's what tells our NG content selector, hey, this content belongs to you when we're in grid mode. Then we need to add our products loop again to create the list. Now we can add the grid view card component, and this component has an input for the product. Now let's add the list view content. Same idea, but with the list attribute this time, and our list specific component. Now, in the real world, this could be anything. These components could take in completely different data, they could include the loop themselves, whatever. But for the purposes of this demo, they both need the product loop, and they both take in the same data. Okay, let's save and see how this works now. Look at that! We're not just toggling classes anymore, we're literally swapping out entire component trees. Click grid, you get grid-specific components. Click list, you get list-specific components. And the best part? Our toggle component doesn't need to know anything about products or cards or rows. It just manages view modes and content projection. So now this component is super flexible. It can be used in multiple ways. The state can be managed externally and we can do anything we need, or we can simply add a grid slot and a list slot and let the component manage the state itself. So we just transformed dead buttons into a smart reusable component that works two ways. One component, multiple personalities, zero headaches. The real power? You're not locked into one approach. This pattern scales beautifully to tabs, theme switchers, or any component that toggles between views. If this helped inspire you, be sure to give it a like and hit subscribe for more patterns that actually make your life easier. Until next time, keep building smarter, not harder, and thanks for watching.